Ferrari, Race to Immortality, is a film about humans. It's a human interest story about men and women who put their lives on the line regularly in pursuit of their dreams. It's a film that should appeal to a wide universal audience. It's got danger, it's got excitement, it's got glamour, and it's got everything you kind of hope to see when you go and watch a movie. Well, as a filmmaker, you're always looking for good stories, and in particular, someone who specialises in sport and human interest stories. This one had everything, because every character within this film you could have made a film about individually. But to have the opportunity to put all five characters together and then have Enzo at the top holding them together, it was too good an opportunity as a filmmaker and a storyteller not to. And it was just so rich with content. I actually had so much content, I was sport for choice. The main difficulty from my side was to home it down and to edit it down and to make a narrative story that had all that integrity and that emotion that these characters lived and portrayed during their existence. You know, the early cuts were long, which is inevitable. And the more we sort of went through the editing process and the more we honed it, the more we crafted the film, I actually don't feel we lost any of the emotional integrity of the story that I wanted to tell. So the duration of the film now and in its final cut, I'm actually very pleased with. There's nothing really left on the cutting room floor that I felt that actually fundamentally would have made a big difference to the film, either editorial or visually. So I'm actually very pleased with the duration, how it's ended up. Yeah, Enzo's a very complex character, and it was interesting because when I started this project, I had a whole different perspective of Enzo as a person than I do now. My whole opinion of Enzo has changed considerably. He was motivated, he was driven, he was focused, but he came from nothing. He had a hard upbringing. He lost his father as a young child, he lost his brother, but he was so self-made and so driven. He knew what he wanted and he went after that. There were obviously lots of side issues with Enzo, and he's got backstories, but like everybody has. Fundamentally, he didn't force anybody to get into his cars. He created this vehicle, he created this racing machine, and drivers wanted to race it. They wanted to get inside the Ferrari and drive it, and he gave them that opportunity. So, unfortunately, there were deaths, a lot of deaths, during the course of it. But Enzo can't really be blamed for that. You know, I wouldn't hold Enzo responsible for that. There were issues. There was talks about disc brakes and issues with some technicalities. But fundamentally, every driver who got into that car chose to get into that car. He didn't force them to. And at the end of the film, I had a real empathy for Enzo as a person. I kind of sat back and think, you know, I just felt much more of empathy for him at the end of the film than I did when we started this project 2 years ago. Why does a driver get into a car? Why push himself to the limit? I mean, fundamentally, you know, they're racers. It's inherently built into their psyche. You put a racing driver in a car, he's going to push it to the limit. Now, whether it was a car, a go-kart, or whatever it might have been, a driver is going to push it to the limit. And I think that's just part of their makeup. That's the difference between a racing driver and just a normal person like me who can drive a car. I could never be a racing driver. And these guys have got something different that sets them apart from the rest of us. You know, what's beautiful about documentary filmmaking, if you've got a true story, if you're starting your process off with a good, true story, then the audience immediately knows that it hasn't been fictionalised, it hasn't been enhanced in any way. What they're seeing is the pure truth of a good story. Where, you know, I love fiction and I love drama, but with a good documentary, there's enough drama rolled into a story such as Race to Immortality that you don't need to fictionalize anything. And that's the beauty of good narrative documentary filmmaking. It's got all the drama you ever could want to or hope to see on the big screen. Yeah, it was a very conscious decision between myself and Julia, the producer, and Paul, the editor, that we wanted to take the viewer back to 1950s and to that decade. So when the film starts, from that opening frame of the film, we transport them back to the decade, and we wanted to hold them into that period and let them stay in that period for 85 minutes. You look and you live and you breathe our racing drivers and their wives and their girlfriends, and so to suddenly reveal them right at the end, visually and editorially, and there's a strong beat within the film, it suddenly brings the audience right the way back to reality, and it's quite a strong conclusion to the film to use that approach and that technique. I would like to think that they, well, first and foremost, hope they enjoy it and they've got a memorable experience. But I would like to actually bring to a whole new audience, bring back these drivers and these brave men and these, as they were quoted, gladiators from the 50s, who were maybe forgotten and they've been lost in time. But actually, they were pioneers and they set a whole new standard for racing. And I would like to introduce, I'd hopefully bring the memories of these great guys and these great racers back to a whole new generation and a whole new audience.